Here I'm asked to solve an absolute value inequality. If you look in the principal notes, this is actually case 3 of the theorem. But we can think of this also as the argument here in absolute value has to be greater than 9. So in other words, the argument 2x minus 1 has to be less than negative 9. So for example, like negative 10. If this was negative 10, in absolute value, certainly that would be greater than 9. 10 is greater than 9. So the argument is less than negative 9, or certainly the argument there, 2x minus 1, could also be greater than 9. Okay, so if you had a 10 here, the absolute value of 10 is greater than 9 as well. Okay, once you have it set up like this, you get two linear inequalities you could solve like normal. So let's go ahead and do that. This leaves me with 2x is less than negative 8, then dividing by 2, x is less than negative 4. So any number less than negative 4 should solve that inequality. Let's look at the second one here, adding 1. This time we get 2x is greater than 10, dividing by 2 here, we're left with all the numbers greater than 5. So all the numbers less than negative 4 and all the numbers greater than 5 should solve the original inequality. Now let's graph all those numbers on a number line. Okay, here's my number line. I'm going to use an open dot and shade all the numbers less than negative 4. All these real numbers solve the original. And I'm also going to shade in all the numbers greater than 5. So I'll use an open dot there as well. And this is the solution set shaded on a number line. Now let's convert that to interval notation. So for this piece we have the interval from minus infinity to negative 4, not inclusive. And for this side we have 5 out to infinity. And so we're going to use a union for that. So this interval unioned with that interval is the interval notation for all the numbers that solve the original inequality.